Good Morning Ambazonia. Today, na number 13 day for the month of May 2021. My name na Kapo Daniel, Sense Pass King, Lukong, Ambazonian Za, una Deputy Defense Chief of the Ambazonia Defense Forces. Fellow Ambazonian, 20th May, it will be the National Day of Resistance, announced by the leader of our War of Liberation, Dr. Chou Ayaba. Ambazonian citizens world over are called upon to celebrate this day by resisting Cameroon rule over our territory, which is without our concern. The chairman of the Ambazonian War Council, Mr. Benedict Kwa, in a message released to the Ambazonian people, have lamented how over the years Ambazonians have been made ridiculed by La République du Cameroun, which successfully made our youth to participate in this charade, mockery of the so-called 20th May National Day of La République du Cameroun, a day which La République du Cameroun captured Ambazonia, subjugated us, and made us to wave their flag, march with their political parties, foolishly celebrating and participating to celebrate and commemorate our own demise as a people and as a nation. 20th May is a day of shame for us. It's a day of mourning. It's a national day where we have to resist a subjugated rule by a foreign government on our territory without our concern. Benedict Kwa call on all Ambazonian citizens them, made them stay for house on 20th May for observe a ghost town, where he go collaborate with the lockdown where he go be implemented by the Ambazonian Defense Forces and all pro-independent groups, sister forces in Ambazonia. Citizens should stop all non-essential traveling during this period, as preparations are being made for the National Day of Resistance coming 20th May. The leader of the Biafran people, Mazi Namdi Kanu, have also made a public statement calling on all Biafran people living in Ambazonia to help observe the Southern Cameroon 20th May as a day to remember the genocidal killings being taken place in Ambazonia by La République du Cameroun. In a statement published by Sahara Reporters, Namdi Kanu reminds all Biafran people in Ambazonia to know that the killings being carried out by Mr. Paul Biya against the people of the territories of the Southern Cameroons are genocide. He also reminds them that the Southern Cameroon is known as Ambazonia, and that the people of Biafra who are living in Ambazonia should listen and observe the instructions that have been provided by Dr. Chou Lucas Ayaba on behalf of our people, for their own interests, for independence. For other news, the people of Oku, they don't get a new chief. Praise Ngum Enes Maleng, then be made the new chief for Insa Oku land. Prince Ngum, he study law and political science, and with the hope, say with the knowledge, he go stand beside his people them as they began commode out for 2018 for demand no political participation for La République du Cameroun in favor of Ambazonian exit from the Cameroon illegal union. 2 days ago, the Ambazonian Defense Forces specialized unit of the Kamansu launched a brazen attack against La République du Cameroun military position in Santa. The operations did not successfully kick out the post that was being targeted by the Ambazonian Defense Forces. We suffered a setback with an injured soldier, but he's doing fine. The Ambazonian Defense Forces will continue to carry out operations to liberate our homeland and to make sure Santa returns under full Ambazonian control. We are calling on the youth in Santa to reach out, to mobilize themselves and prepare for another wave of complete takeover of Santa. The setbacks in Santa That was as a result of La République du Cameroun infiltration of most of the forces that were in Santa are gradually being reversed. We have had a good understanding on how La République du Cameroun had manipulated its way through facilitators that enabled them to get a foothold of positions in Santa. For many other areas around Ambazonia, the Ambazonia Defense Forces would receive a lot of challenges due to the program being run and sponsored by the UNDP, which they call a recovery program that La République du Cameroun is parading as its government reconstruction program. The Ambazonia Governing Council have been engaged with the UNDP to study the program, which it was meant to alleviate our people from the humanitarian crisis being caused by the war. These so-called recovery programs are directly affecting the dynamics on the ground, as an entire district in the great state of Lebialem have had confused reaction with the installation of a major Ambazonian Defense Forces barracks in Lebialem due to an expected project being sponsored by the UNDP. Application have been made to the Governing Council and the Ambazonian Defense Forces to this regard to consider projects being sponsored by the UNDP in our territory as not being consistent with our liberation movement for the moment, for a complete ban of such projects within Ambazonian territory. The results of such applications will be made public once we have them. In another news, La République du Cameroun then buy new equipment them for United Nations project where their government they fight for Goduam, for instance, Central African Republic. As the war they go on for Central African Republic, the La République du Cameroun, it is see am like opportunity for take contract them for be peacekeepers. We didn't see previously soldier the way La République be send them for Central African Republic for go do United Nations peacekeeping force. They become back, their salaries, their arrears, their benefits and be all be seized and be eaten by this corrupt official them for La République du Cameroun. As the United Nations pour in more and more money for inside Central African Republic, La République, it don't buy military equipment them for get contract for send soldier them meet and go work for Central Africa so that they get some more money. The economy of La République is in shambles. Details will be provided in our subsequent presentation in the No Koni Talk show, which we expect to air today on our national television, the ACN. Great work is being done in the background for a second wave of explosive attacks against La République du Cameroun forces throughout Ambazonian territory. The first wave of IED attacks against La République du Cameroun convoy have completely halted their task force led by General Nka from launching any further attack against Ambazonian villages within the past 2 weeks, even though the occupation forces have made an incursion in Alabukam, an operation which we believe was to distract the Bamenda Brigade, while under the cover of night, La République du Cameroun have brought in 13 trucks of Brasserie du Cameroun product to stock it in Bamenda. Brasserie du Cameroun is a banned product in Ambazonia, and Ambazonian forces, sister forces, and citizens are all called to participate to bring down any such property that is being used to store Brasserie du Cameroun or sell Brasserie drinks within Ambazonia. According to information we are gathering, such products will be offered on credit to suppliers and to off-license across our territories and in the Savannah State. Off-license bars that sells Brasserie du Cameroun should understand that there can be consequences as a result of doing this contraband. I will want to take this opportunity to inform our people that Alliance Française have been banned and asked to leave Ambazonia. Their head officer, who is in Bamenda, is a double agent operating as a spy in Bamenda. Information are coming forth from soldiers who have encountered him, trying to recruit them and gather intelligence regarding our activities for liberation. citizens and forces should do their patriotic duty to enforce this ban. Alliance Française staff members are unwelcome and unwanted people. We have observed the activities that have demonstrated their evacuation, but it's inconclusive. 99 days for a thief and 1 day for the owner. Kapo Daniel, signing out. See you tonight on the No Koni Talk Show, ECN. God bless you. Bye.